Hi all, how are you? Okay, years ago, working in another company, my boss told me that there was a lack of disk space, and that's why we had to stop doing backups. Weeks later, when someone accidentally deleted 4 terabytes of data, he asked me why we didn't have backups. I was totally indignant, and I told him, backup is for cowards. Of course, we never talk about it again, and since then, we have backup all our systems. Today, we are going to see how backup is also important in Kubernetes environments and how Velero can help us to make that backup. My name is Manrique García. I work as OpenShift Tan in Red Hat, and my colleague.
Hello, my name is José Manuel Marquez Alhambra. I work also in the Manrique team. As an OpenShift Tan, I've been using Linux several years ago, and well, I joined Red Hat in January 2022.
Okay, this is what we are going to see today. First, we will see a little bit of what Velero is and its functionalities. We also review what weakness Velero currently has, and then we will analyze the requirements for installation of Velero. Finally, we will show a demo with three Velero use cases. Velero is an open source project providing tools to backup, restore, and migrate your Kubernetes cluster resources and persistent volumes. It's a cloud-native Kubernetes optimized approach to backup and restore, enabling data protection use cases no matter where your cluster is running. The word restore is important. A backup will never be complete if you don't test a restore to ensure that the backup is consistent. Because of its characteristics, Kubernetes environments historically have not been very good with backups and restores. What do we backup? This is necessary to backup our cluster. Wouldn't it be faster to deploy again? These are questions that are often asked when you implement a project with Kubernetes. However, our customers need that backup. It may be easy to redeploy a Kubernetes clusters and all its applications, but many of them have persistent data that we need to secure. Also, it might be by some mistake, we have lost only a portion of data on our persistent volumes. Are you going to deploy an entire cluster from scratch to recover a small subset of data? Velero is also very useful in other use cases, such as migrating applications between Kubernetes clusters in an agnostic way. Since in addition to securing our data, we can also backup all the objects that we have in our namespace. So we can restore an application in any other Kubernetes cluster, forgetting what type the cluster it is. Velero now is in the version 1.13.2. Previously, the project has known as ftarc. You can see they have the present in GitHub, and it's a VMware support project. Unlike other tools, which directly access the Kubernetes etc database to perform backup and restores, Velero uses the Kubernetes API to capture the state of cluster resources and to restore them when is necessary. This API-driven approach has a number of key benefits. Backups can capture subsets of the cluster resources, filtering by namespace, resource type, and/or level selector, providing a high degree of flexibility around what's backup and restore. Users of managed Kubernetes often don't have access to the underlying etcd database, so direct backups and restores are not possible. Resource exposed through aggregated API servers can easily be backup and restored, even if they are stored in separate etc database. As main functionalities, it gives us the possibility of perform on-demand backups anytime and in timely manner. We can also make a schedule of the backups to able make them periodically and have different types of retentions. The restores can be done in the same cluster or in any other Kubernetes cluster. We can also do restores in more granular way. For example, if we want to restore only a certain type of objects of a namespace or some specific physical volumes. Velero works both on-premise and in a public cloud. For persistent data, we have two options. Use RESTIC or Copia. This allows us to backup any type of volume that we have, or use the snapshot capabilities with CSI. For snapshot, we have the possibility to add a data mover or not. With data mover, we can move our snapshot to another storage, different from the volume we want to backup. This way, we provide a better data security, because if we leave the snapshot in the same storage as the original volume, if we have a problem in that storage, we will lose both. The volume and the snapshot data mover helps us to migrate the rig. The user can pre-configure one or more possible backup storage locations and one or more volume snapshot locations, and can select at backup creation time the location in which the backup and associated snapshots should be stored. This configuration design enables a number of different use cases. Okay, as everything in life, Velero has its weaknesses, among them we can point out. The first is a grid dependence on VMware in the Velero community. Another weak is there is no support for backing up resources in object storage. These backups have to be done manually for the moment. To ensure the consistency of the backup data, is necessary to take in account the quiescencing. It's necessary to use hooks of the applications to pause them and ensure the consistency of the data. For the data mover, you need the CSI driver to have the support to do it. You also need to have Kubernetes greater than 120 and the mount propagation functionality that allows for the volume shares to a container to mount that volume in another container or the same pod, even in a pod that belongs to the same cluster. Velero uses object storage to store backups and associated artifacts. It also successfully integrates with supported block storage systems to snapshot your persistent volumes. Before beginning the installation process, you should identify the object storage provider and optional block storage provider you'll be using. Velero allows you to take snapshots of persistent volumes as part of your backups. If you're using one of the supported cloud providers block storage, like EBS volumes or Azure Managed Disk or WordPress in this. Velero also has RESTIC and Copia integration to give you an out-of-the-box solution for backing up and restoring almost any type of Kubernetes volume. This integration is in addition to Velero's capabilities, not a replacement for existing functionality. If you are running on AWS and taking EBS snapshots, a part of your regular Velero backups, there is no need to switch to using RESTIC. However, if you need volume as a snapshot plugin for your storage platform, if you are using EFS or Azure File or any other volume type that doesn't have a native snapshot concept, RESTIC and Copia might be for you. And that's all from my side. We'll hear some links to the documentation, and I hand over to my colleagues.
Okay. So in this case, as we don't have too much time, we have chosen three scenarios. No? So we have an EKS cluster running on Azure. So we can see that our cluster looks healthy. And we have three applications in three different namespaces. We have the first scenario is a simple web app application, so it's only a deployment with a service. No? So we can have a look into the service. And we can see that this is an Azure load balancer that is publishing our web application. No? So we are going to connect to it. So it's simple. Returns and it works message. So now that we are going to do is to create a backup from this application, and we are going to delete the namespace to simulate a failure, and we are going to restore it. So with this command, we are going to create a backup for the application one namespace with a TTL of 1 hour. That means that after 1 hour, our backup is going to be deleted. So. I think that I made a mistake. Increase namespaces in progress. So now the backups has been submitted successfully. So we are going to have a look into the backup description. Now as the backup is running, probably the command will take some time to return the information, but that the backup is copying the data into our Azure container. We have been running on Azure a container, and in the container will be all the data there. So we can see that the backup has been completed, and we can have a look into the Azure container. So we have a folder, backups, and we have the application 01 backup. So we can see that the backup has been performed successfully. So now that we are going to do is to delete the namespace. And wait until the application is deleted. So now we are like simulating a failure, and we want to restore the application, no? Because when the namespace is deleted, I am not going to be able to connect to the application again. So probably it will take some time until the pod is deleted and all the resources are clean. And also, as we have an Azure load balancer, the command will take some time. So now the namespace has been deleted. We can check it. And now we only have application 2 and 3. And if I try to connect to the application, now it's not going to work. So we are going to restore the backup. So we are going to create our restore from the previous backup. So now the restore has been scheduled successfully, and we're going to have a look into it. As this is a simple application, the backup and the restore is not going to take too much time. So there are 10 items that have been restored. We are going to have a look into it. So we have our application one namespace again. We have our deployment with two replicas. And we have our service again. So we are going to connect into it. Probably will take some time because the application has created again. So the service will be available. But after some time, it should return our web server application. So now it is working again. Okay. So this is the first scenario. And in the second scenario, we are going to create another backup. But in this case, we have a second web server application. But in this example, we have a persistent volume. So the application has a persistent volume attached to it, and we have mounted the persistent volume into the Apache's root directory document. So we are going to connect to the pod, and we are going to have a look into it. So we can see that we have a persistent volume that it is mounted into the Apache's root directory. and we have a service to connect to this application. And in this case, we have modified the in the document, and we have customized the message. So now we are going to create a backup from this namespace, and we are going to delete it. In this occasion, as we have a persistent volume, we have introduced a new flag. That is, default volume is to file system backup true, because we want to have the backup from the PVCs, no? And we have submit the backup successfully. So if we return to the S3 Explorer, we can see that now we have more folders. No? We have a backup folder, we have backup 1 and backup 2. In this, we have the backup of the YAMLs. No? And we have another new folder that is copia. And in this case, we have Velero has created a backup repository for us. And in this repository is storing the data from the PVC. No? Now, so now we have like two scenarios, no? The applications backups and also the persistent volume backup. And also Velero has created a restore folder for us, because as we have created a restore previously, we have another resource in the S3. So we are going to have a look into the backup 2 and should be completed. So in this case, has completed a pod volume backups. And also the backup is complete. We are going to delete the namespace 2. And well, meanwhile we can see some resources that Velero has created for us. For example, Velero has created a pod volume backup, and in this pod volume backup, the backup has mounted the PVC and has uploaded the data into Azure. No? And also, we should have a backup repository. That is the repository that we saw previously in the S3 storage. So the namespace has been deleted. Now the curl command should not work because we have deleted the namespace. And we are going to restore it. And now Velero is restoring the namespace. So as the YAML files are going to be restored, also Velero is creating a pod volume restore and is doing the opposite direction from the backup. No? So it's creating a temporary pod, and in that pod is mounting the PVC and is copying the data from Azure to our PVC. No? And after that, the restore application will mount the PVC and so we'll have the data available again. So we can see the restore progress, and in this case it has created a copy of restore, and also the restore has been complete. In this occasion we have more items restored than previously, no? Because now we have a PV and a PVC. So the pod is running. We have our service again. And we have our PVC. and now the application has been restored with the data also. No? And the last scenario is an application which is a MariaDB database. So in this case, that we are going to do is we are going to introduce a hook to stop the database while the backup is doing. No? So we can have this to ensure the consistency of the database. So we have a deployment, and in this case, if we have a look into the YAML file, we can see that we have introduced some annotations. No? We have added annotation to put the database in read-only. And also to put some time to this, we want to also to sleep the database while the backup is doing. No? So we are going to have like 2 minutes while we launch the backup, and we want to ensure that the backup is in read-only mode, and also we are going to try to insert new data, and it should fail, no? Because we have 2 minutes while the database is going to be in read-only mode. No? Also in this namespace, we have another PPC. We are going to connect into the database, and we can have a look into it. So we have the MySQL data mounted into the PPC. For example, we have chosen this table, no category. So now we are going to add a new row. To introduce the new row, and we are going to call it DevConf1 with the today's date. So now we have added the one row, and we are going to prepare the command to add another row, but not we are not going to execute it yet. So now we are going to create the backup. Well, the backup is launched, and now we are going to see the Velero logs to ensure that the hook is working. So now you can see that the webhook has been launched, and if we try to insert a new row, it should fail because the database is in read-only mode. So you can use this mechanism to avoid that the database is in inconsistent state. No? So now, the data is in read-only mode, so you cannot add new data until the backup is complete successfully. No? So this scenario is good for databases or another application that you need to ensure the data consistency. Also, In this case, the backup will take some time, no? As we introduce the delay, the 2 minutes delay. But also, if you use another scenario, like for example, Marquez explained previously, snapshot CSE drivers, you can use that scenario because the snapshot will take some seconds, no, to be taken, and after that, the backup will be running in the background, no. The backups will be complete soon. I think that maybe if the hook was executed, this will take some seconds until the security is executed again. Okay. Now the backup only is finishing, so yes. The 2 minutes has finished, and if we try to add the data, this is still in the read-only mode. Now the data has been inserted. So we have the new row, and the backup should finish. Also, with Velero, we have the backup resource, so we can have a look into it, and show it in a YAML format, no? So we can see more data here, and we can see also that the backup has been completed successfully. So we're going to remove the namespace, and we are going to restore it. Now we only have application 1 and application 2. Application 3 has been deleted, and we are going to restore it. In this case, as we have some data into the PVC, the restore will take some seconds, but it will take more time than the previous backup, no? Because in the previous backup we only had one file, but in this case we have more files as we have a database. So we can see that also we have a pod volume backup and pod volume restore. So as the backup was completed successfully, we can see that all the incomplete status and also the first one is going completed and the second one is running. So the restore has been complete and we're going to have a look into it. So we have the application 3 namespace. We have our data again in the PVC. And we only have the row DevConf 1 because we run the second insert when the backup was finished, no? So we have the data that we expected to have. So that is all from our side. So I don't know if you have questions. Go ahead.
So I think what you showed us is really nice. Does this tool work outside of Kubernetes?
So you are asking if Velero works in another cluster that are not Kubernetes clusters, no?
Let's forget about the cluster. Does it work on bare metal?
On bare metal, but with Kubernetes or without Kubernetes? I don't think so, because at the end Velero is for Kubernetes system, but I can check it and we can have a private conversation after this and have a look into it. But as far as I know, Velero only works in Kubernetes systems. Okay, go ahead.
Yes, nowadays you have two mechanisms to do the backups. You can use RESTIC and you can use COPIA. If you use COPIA, you can have incremental backups because at the end you have a repository created in these three storages and the backups will be incremental. What else? Capabilities. As far as I know, the incremental capabilities, and also, you are asking if. So you are asking if COPIA or RESTIC have different features, no, or something like that, features that are available in COPIA or RESTIC or. I need to have a look into it, but as far as I know, the incremental backups are only available in COPIA and also the data mover. As Manrique explained previously, the data mover only works with COPIA, not with RESTIC. And also the performance is better with COPIA than RESTIC. I didn't catch you well. So, are you asking to use? You are asking to use Velero in your data center, for example, no? Using your own installation instead of managed services, no? Using your Kubernetes cluster instead of using AKS, for example, no? Yes, you can run that also. Yes, it works. So in our example, we choose a managed service as we created the backup on Azure, but you can run in each Kubernetes. Because you need at the end an S3 provider. So you need an S3 and you can use Amazon, Azure, Google Cloud, or also you can use your own S3 storage. So if you have, for example, Minio or something like that, you can also use that. Anything else? Okay, so that is all from our side. Thank you for joining us.